We tested 4 brands of water pumps and we are surprised with the results. Magkano kaya ang dagdag sa bill mo kada water pump na ginagamit mo? Totoo kaya ang mga claims ng packaging nila? Magkakaalaman na. Kung gusto mong malaman, kaya tara! This is Bits and Fishes and we believe the more we know about our hobbies, the more we enjoy it. Watch out somewhere in the video and we will be flashing a discount code for these water pumps. We will also be giving away 2 water pumps sa mga top engagers of this month. Alright, going back, maraming katanungan about water pumps. Ano ba talaga ang dapat na water pump para sa aquarium ko? Ano ba ang dapat na flow rate? Alin daw ang mas maliit na kumain ng kuryente, alin din ang malakas? At sino kaya ang nagsasabi sa kanila ng totoo? Ilan lang yan sa mga katanungan about sa mga water pumps natin. So in this video, we will be testing how much can they really fill in gallons per hour compared to their package claim. Also, we will be testing their actual flow per hour in their optimal max height versus the claim max height ng kanilang packaging. And we will be testing the actual wattage consumption and how much they cost per month. First, alamin muna natin ang iba't ibang mga flow rate at iba-ibang brands na itetest natin. Alright, we have the C-Billion 303 claiming 800 liters per hour flow rate and power consumption of 8 watts. And another 800 liters per hour is the Sequest 800 consuming 12 watts and the Switch SW7 consuming only 7 watts and claims 800 liters per hour. Since AquaSpeed do not have an 800 liters per hour water pump, we have the AquaSpeed A1100 at 1100 liters per hour consuming only 7 watts, same as the Switch SW7. Sometime before, there have been rumors that AquaSpeed is lying about their power consumption, but this time, they are claiming 50% energy saving. We also got their big brothers, the C-Billion 304, claiming at 1500 liters per hour at 10 watts, AquaSpeed A2000 claiming at 2000 liters per hour at only 13 watts. The Sequest 2200 claiming 2200 liters per hour at 25 watts power usage. And the Switch SW35 claiming 2500 at 25 watts as well. Now there is a reason why we want to test 2 flow rate speed for each brand. At malalaman nyo yan sa huli. Did you know how much flow rate is the right for your tank? For saltwater aquariums, requires about 10 to 15 times your tank volume per hour. For reef tank, requires 20 to 40 times your tank volume per hour again. For planted tanks, requires 3 to 5 times only the volume of your tank, which is a lower flow to avoid disturbing the plants and the substrate. And freshwater fish aquariums requires 4 to 6 times the volume of your tank. Now for our freshwater fish, meron yung reason bakit your tank volume has to cycle 4 to 6 times in 1 hour. First reason is for efficient filtration. Your water not only has to collect particles but also the dirty water that has to be cleansed through the biological media. There must be enough contact time with the water and the bacteria to convert the ammonia to a safer element. Also, good circulation prevents accumulation of debris on dead spots. Another reason is for surface agitation for oxygenation. The 4-6 turnover ensures oxygenated water is distributed evenly through the tank. So how do you calculate how much flow rate does your tank need? Simply lang, just multiply your tank volume 4-6 times your actual tank volume including your water volume for your filtration. And that's it! Pero the question is, are these pumps really are providing the exact flow rate? And if you're considering the cost, mapapatanong ka din magkano ang isang water pump magkukos sa inyong monthly bill. So we prepared a water container and pumped water to a 15-gallon tank and we will time it kailan niya mapupuno yung 15-gallon tank. We also use this power consumption tester to get the actual wattage it is consuming and let it run for 1 hour and calculate from it the monthly consumption based on our local kilowatt per hour. So just a disclaimer, this may not be the same with your area and we'll just give you an idea on how much it will cost. First, we tested the water pumps at 1.5 feet lift like the usual in the tank setup, pumping out to a top sump and see how much flow they can provide compared to their claimed flow. Then we tested their max height lift and how much flow they can still provide. At the same time, we tested how much wattage they actually can consume at a specific lift. Then we let each water pump run for 1 hour and test it out how much power it will consume and how much it will cost in 1 month. By the way, this video is not sponsored and we bought all these pumps from our own pocket. And we spent about 16 to 20 hours to make this video. We're not asking for any donations, but we hope you support us by watching this video till the end of it, liking this video and sharing this to your friends who are also interested in this kind of video. And if you like this type of videos, feel free to follow us in our social media channels. Or if you want to take your support further, you can support our Shopee store and purchase your fishkeeping needs in our store. We also want to tell you about our prebiotics with astaxanthin product, and this is the most affordable, effective pet probiotics, and this means you can give this to your fish, dogs, cats, birds, and other pet animals. Probiotic improves immune system, improves gut health, it's an antioxidant, color enhancer, improves breeding quality, improves stress resilience to your pets, and improves skin quality. Now, to use Probi, you can soak your favorite pellets with enough amount of Probi, or if you want to feed it to your pets, you can also soak this with your dog food, cat food, or with their water. Check the comment section for the link. Alright, going back to our test. So for the Sibillion, HY303 has a strong flow and lives up to its claimed max height at 1.3 meters or 4 feet. Though it is full short on its promise, which only produced 567 liters at 1.5 feet climb against its 800 liters per hour claim, but again, Sibillion is the closest to all promises, which is 70% of its promised flow. Possibly, it can live up its claim of 800 liters per hour at zero climb. But that's not how we use water pumps, right? At maximum height of 4.0 feet, it was able to provide flow of 45 gallons per hour at 5.4 watts only. The Sibillion HY303 can be used on 20 to 30 gallon tank on a 1.5 to 2 feet height lift climb, and be able to do 5 cycles in 1 hour. And as an addition to your monthly bill, it can consume about 57 pesos only when at 6.3 watts compared to its claim wattage of 8 watts. We recommend the HY303 for an in-tank pump of a 20 to 30 gallon tank not higher than 2 feet high to fill in a top sump, though it can lift water up to 4 feet high from an undersump, but no more than a 10 gallon tank only. Now, the Sibillion 304 has a very strong flow and lives up to its max height of 1.6 or 5.2 feet, but it is short for its max flow. Instead of 1,500 liters or 396 gallons per hour, it only provided 1,128 liters or 298 gallons. And full short about 100 gallons, but still, that's 75% of its promised flow. And at maximum height of 1.6 meters or 5.2 feet, it provided about 58 gallons per hour, which you can use in an aquaponic setup not higher than 4 feet at lowest wattage of 10 watts. So at a regular height of 1.2 to 2 feet, it is considering its actual flow and it can provide, it can be used for a 50 to 60 gallon tank at about 13 to 14 watts. And it will cost you about probably 180 to 200 pesos per month to your monthly electricity bill. But the Sibillion 304 can go over the claimed power consumption at a lower climb, which is 13.3 watts already, and only meet the 10 watt claim at 4 feet climb. So therefore, since the 304 has strong flow even at 4 feet, you can use this for undersumps and still get the claimed wattage, but only for 10 to 15 gallon tank, since it can only provide 58 gallons per hour. Now, the AquaSpeed A1100 did not disappoint us with power consumption. It lived up to its package pitch of Green Series 50% energy saving, consuming only half of the wattage claim consumption of 7 watts, at 2 feet height, consuming 3.6 watts and only 4 watts at 1 feet height. The higher it gets, the lower consumption. But power saving might have compromised the flow it can provide. At 1.5 feet climb, it only provided 272 liters compared to its promised flow of 1,100 liters per hour. At maximum height of 2 feet, it can only provide 19.5 gallons per hour only. And in its claimed max height of 1.6 meters or 5 feet, it can no longer provide water flow. Using the AquaSpeed A1100 at 3.5 to 4 watts, you only be spending about 43 pesos per month on your electricity bill. Considering its max flow at 1.5 to 2 feet, this can only be used within a 5 cycle of water for a 15-gallon tank. With its low maximum height capability, we recommend the AquaSpeed A1100 for an in-tank water pump out to filter of a 10 to 15-gallon tank of not more than 2 feet high. Now let's go to the AquaSpeed 2000. It promises 2000 liters or 528 gallons per hour, but at 1.5 feet, it only provided 556 liters or 147 gallons, that is only 27% of its promised flow rate. With its promised max height of 1.6 meters or 5.2 feet, it was only able to provide an optimal flow of 1.2 meters or 4 feet of 33 gallons per hour. AquaSpeed stands by its green energy saving series, and AquaSpeed A2000 has the lowest power consumption at 13 watts claimed. Our reading says it has only consuming 8.8 watts at 3 feet and 6.8 watts at 4 feet, and it can only be an approximate additional 100 pesos to your monthly electricity bill. So our recommendations for the AquaSpeed A2000: with optimal flow of 20 to 30 gallon tank with an in-tank setup lifting the water around 1.5 to 2 feet high. Though we cannot recommend the A2000 for an undersump setup, although it can lift water up to 4 feet, but in its minimal flow of 33 gallons per hour, which is unable to cycle your tank water 5 times as recommended. Going to the Sequest 800, as expected with 800 liters per hour, it only provided 111 gallons or 420 liters per hour at 1.5 feet lift. That is 52% of the claimed flow rate. It claimed to have a maximum height of 0.98 meters or 3.2 feet, and yet it was still able to provide 63 gallons per hour flow. Using the Sequest 800 at 3 feet, it was able to consume power of 8.7 watts and 10.0 watts at 1 foot lift, compared to its claimed wattage of 12 watts. At 10 watts, you will be paying about 100 pesos additional to your electric bill. We recommend the Sequest 800 be used in an in-tank water pump for a 10 to 20 gallon at 2 feet high top sump. We can recommend it using it for a bottom sump, though it can lift water up to 3.2 feet, but it can only provide 63 gallons per hour, which can cycle 5 times only for a 10 to 12 gallon tank. Okay, lastly, we have the Switch SW7, which we also promised 800 liters per hour, and was only able to provide 33 gallons or 124 liters an hour, which is only 15% of the claimed water flow of 800 liters, and claimed to have a max height of 1.2 meters or 3.9 feet, but its maximum height that provided an optimal flow is only up to 1 feet height provided. We still can recommend the SW7 for small tanks like a 5-gallon tank or nano tanks with a top sump, as it can circulate a 5-gallon tank 5 times its capacity in 1 hour. This is the cheapest among the pumps, which only adds up 28 pesos per month to your electricity bill. But on the other hand, the Switch SW35 promises 2,500 liters per hour or 660 gallons. Unfortunately, it only provided 180 gallons or 681 liters, or 27% of the promised flow rate against the 2,500 liters per hour claim. Surprisingly, it was able to reach 6.5 feet out of the 8 feet claim and can provide 31 gallons per hour. So the Switch SW35 can cycle a 30 to 35 gallon tank for 5 times in 1 hour. Maybe you can use the SW35 as an undersump for a 15 to 20 gallon tank at 3 to 4 feet lift. At this range of water flow at max height, it can consume about 25 watts, which is 237 pesos in 1 month additional to your electric bill. But again, for only 15 to 35 gallon tank, which is expensive for your monthly electricity bill, but it is budget friendly. And here are the summary for our tests. The sea billion are consistent with their water flow around 70 to 75% and consistent to their max height claim and still able to provide minimal flow. The 303 may cost you around 57 pesos per month, while the 304 may cost you around 151 pesos per month. The sea billion is not as expensive as the sequest. The sequest are consistent to provide about 45 to 50% of their promised flow, though they consume more power than the sea billion, and the sequest has a strong flow, but it is an expensive choice and 2 times costly for your monthly bill compared to sea billion. The rumored AquaSpeed to have higher consumption than their claim wattage has redeemed their reputation regarding power consumption, consuming almost half of their claim wattage, but unfortunately, their water flow went down at 25% flow against their claimed liters per hour. If you compare the price to the sea billion, it wouldn't be your best choice. Though this is power saving on the better side, but if it's the only available pump in your favorite pet supply shop, just consider 25% is the actual flow of the claimed flow rate in the box. Now, the cheapest of the bunch is the Switch water pumps. Both model provides below 30% of the actual flow rate against their actual claim in the box. If you are budget-driven, Switch is the best choice. Its low flow saves you electric power consumption, but just be mindful of the actual flow that you need. The SW35 is at par with the AquaSpeed A2000, providing almost the same flow rate, and the SW35 has a high max rate, so it's a little more powerful than the AquaSpeed A2000, if you don't mind the bucket shape in your tank or pond. Okay, that's 16 to 20 hours creating this video, and I hope this video gives you insight on your next water pump purchase decision. Or you may want to decide to change your water pumps to save your electricity bill. If you want to do that, here's a 10 peso voucher for your next water pump purchase, and we have a bundle add-on discount on Probi products and fish pellet products. So visit our Shopee store now. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching till the end of this video. Don't forget to follow us and subscribe. This is again Bits and Fishes.